A new CDC study shows people who were infected with COVID-19 and then fully vaccinated had the best protection from the dangerous Delta variant. Here to answer your questions about that and much more, Dr. Todd Ellerin, Chief of Infectious Diseases at South Shore Health. Good to see you as always, Doctor.
Hello, Dr. T. Great to see you. So this is a very large study. It looked at about 1.1 million cases in the United States, but all of the infections occurred before the arrival of Omicron. So the question is, what can we learn from those results?
There's a lot we can learn, Ed. And this was a large study done by the CDC, you know, New York and California, over 1.1 million people. This is what it showed. Overall, there's no question that the most vulnerable groups were the patients that were unvaccinated and not previously infected. Now, what's interesting is it looked at two different time periods. When the Alpha variant was circulating back in the spring, it's interesting that those who were vaccinated were protected against infection more than those that had been previously infected. Mm-hmm. But then when you jump forward to the summer and this past fall when Delta was circulating, a prior infection actually protected better than vaccination did. But like Maria opened with, mm-hmm. those that were vaccinated and infected had the best protection. So one, I think this study can help change our thinking. We shouldn't just think of people as unvaccinated or vaccinated, right, but more as protected or vulnerable, because you can be protected from by previous infection or by getting vaccinated, boosted, et cetera.
Got it.
Okay, so before I get to the next question, when I said fully vaccinated, does that mean with this particular study, two shots and a booster shot, or was it just the two shots?
Okay, great point. This study wasn't done during a time of boosting.
And
like
okay.
you said, this does not reflect the Omicron era. The
okay.
CDC will have to update us when they get that data on Omicron.
All right, so we identified, the United States identified its first case of COVID 2 years ago today. Now 25% of Americans, they still have not received a single shot. So what do you say to those people? Do you still try to persuade them, or do you think it's just time to move on, as in your expert opinion?
It is definitely not time to move on. I just came from a patient right now in one of our units that is young, previously healthy, unvaccinated, and right now fighting for her breath on about 15 liters of oxygen, okay? And as her oxygen saturations decline, we have to consider the possibility that she may need to be intubated. So it's definitely not too late. Again, like we just talked about, I think the key here is that we can't have compassion fatigue, okay? And we have to keep the dialogue open. We have to understand people that don't choose to be vaccinated, but we don't want to end the conversation mm-hmm. there, because it's still not too late. The COVID-19 is going to be with us for a long time, and we know that vaccination and prior infection protect people against hospitalization and severe outcomes.
Dr. T, let's get to a viewer question, and this one is from Jane. She says, I'm an adult with comorbidities who got my Pfizer booster 6 months ago. Is a fourth shot of Pfizer now available? If, where, and how can I get one?
Great and timely question, Jane. Okay, so here's the answer. If you're immunocompromised, then the answer is yes. Remember, for immunocompromised patients, the CDC is recommending three doses as part of that primary series, really in a row, about a month apart. But then a fourth dose now 5 months after the third dose. So now that it's January, mm-hmm. people are becoming eligible for that. But here's the but. The fourth dose is not recommended right now for the general population. And Israel just conducted a study of about 270 patients. All had gotten three doses of Pfizer and then a mix between the fourth dose of Pfizer and Moderna. And overall, there was a boost in antibodies, but it wasn't really any more than the third dose. And unfortunately, it looked like it didn't protect that well against Omicron. So I think that it's we're not ready for prime time for the fourth dose. The good news is that those Omicron-specific sequence vaccines are on the way, and hopefully by the spring or early summer, that will be something that's here that can protect us better against the Omicron variant.
Dr. T, thank you very much.
Thank you, doctor. Be well.